I'm Steve Jacobs. I'm the Environmental Services Director here at Retrofit Companies. I'm responsible for the compliance here at Retrofit, and I wanted to talk a little bit today about preparing batteries for shipment. A lot of people ask why they have to go through all the hassle of packaging batteries properly for DOT shipment, and I just want to illustrate the fact that there's still a lot of energy left over in many batteries that are shipped for recycling. And this is just a regular lead acid battery that would be found in emergency lighting. It has been sent to us for recycling. And I'm just going to take a little bit of steel wool and just show you as a conductor across the two terminals what happens if it was to come in contact with just a metal container or something else. This burn like that would possibly start the whole package on fire, yeah, and thus maybe even the truck.
All right, so we'll start with the ubiquitous car battery. These are a lead acid battery. DOT requires that we protect the terminals, both the positive and negative. Sometimes you'll see positive is red and negative is black. In this case, there is no differentiation between the two. In this case, we've sprayed them with this undercoating to completely cover the metallic terminals. Alternatively, you could use packing tape. It tends not to stick to dirty batteries very well, but the undercoating does a little bit better job. Again, a lead acid battery. These are considered to be gel cells. They're a gel electrolyte battery. Very similar in construction, but these are found in emergency lighting in buildings. Same kind of thing. You have a red positive terminal and a black negative terminal, and both of those have to be protected. We typically use clear packing tape. It tends to stick to these pretty well because they're oftentimes just a little bit dusty, but not real oily or dirty. So the next category we have is nickel cadmium. Nickel cadmium batteries you often find in power tools, any sort of handheld device that takes a lot of energy. In this case, you see that both the positive and negative terminal, the metal contacts there, are recessed a bit. We still encourage our customers to put tape over the top of that. They are very close to the top, and so any contact with metal would cause a short and thus a fire. Similarly, we have another style, two different styles of nickel cadmium or nickel metal hydride. This would be like the back of a cell phone or a walkie-talkie type radio. You can see that there's contact for both the radio side and for maybe dropping into a charger. And then this style here, which must have fit into some kind of device and then had power leads running to maybe a motor or switch or something. In this case, the black and the red leads had connectors on them and would be, it would be a possible short situation, so they are taped. This category is lithium primary cells. Lithium is a broad category of batteries that have very high energy densities. They're the newer style batteries you'll find in everything from laptops, power tools, you name it, motherboards on computers. These batteries have a very long life, often up to 20 years that they'll hold their energy. And so thus having a lot of energy, it's critical that we actually tape these up properly. You'll see that this whole bundle of primary cells, somebody has used packing tape and put both sides. There's no way for a positive terminal or a negative terminal to short on anything metallic. These are coin cells taped in a similar manner. Here are some examples of laptop batteries. These are the kind that would just fit in the back of a laptop, snap in place. They oftentimes have a small connector that fits towards the laptop, kind of a copper color. These are the same type of chemistry, even though that they're in a flat, very thin design compared to those round or button cell. Probably the highest energy density of all batteries. DOT is very concerned lately that these are completely taped, no matter what their voltage is. Prevent fires. So this is a lithium ion battery, and it doesn't look like anything I'd recognize. Most people probably wouldn't unless you had purchased it. Oftentimes you have to really search around on a label and find the chemistry. You can see it's a lithium ion chemistry. Again, 117.6 watt hours, an incredible amount of power in this battery, even residual. In this case, we've used packing tape on the back side. These have recessed terminals, so they're probably pretty safe. We make sure that our customers and our own company is going the extra step in making sure that these are secure. They're protected for shipment. So the last category of batteries that we want to talk about today are your standard dry cell alkaline batteries. Most people are very familiar with these for flashlights or small radios, that sort of thing, AA, AAA. These are basically a relatively safe battery in its used form for recycling. DOT is encouraging people to cover the terminals, but it is not necessary in all cases. If it's 9 volts or less, they can be shipped in a safe manner in a durable container. They would like you to ship them in a way, in a manner that would prevent shorting. So we encourage people to either use tape or we use Ziploc bags for small batteries too. That's another great way to do it. So if you have these, you can put them in the cheapest Ziploc bag, the smallest bag you can find. If you don't have tape or something like that, it's a great way to protect them. So there's a lot to know about battery packaging and proper DOT shipment, and we've got experts here on hand that can help you anytime. Our customer service people, our salespeople, can provide you with guidance documents, or you can call our office and talk to any one of our people on the hazardous waste team.